When Liberty Park was first acquired, we saw right away that in addition to some really incredible natural resources that we were able to protect and conserve in their really pristine state, we also saw that there was opportunity to go back and restore some features that had been impacted over time. In particular, probably the biggest opportunity that we saw for restoration was Pond Brook. Pond Brook is the dominant aquatic feature of Liberty Park. It is really not a brook, or at least it's not a brook anymore. Pond Brook was essentially, when we acquired the property, a ditch that flowed from north to south through the entire park. It had originally been a stream and wetland complex that was ditched over a century ago to accommodate surrounding agriculture. The agriculture use of the area is now gone. It is now a natural area park, and our goal was to restore it to the most natural state that we could. The project began in 2004, and it was actually recently completed in 2020. It was a long project. It was one of our longest running restoration projects. Altogether, we've been able to restore over 5 miles of stream, 100 acres of wetland, and we've been able to restore this aquatic feature to a warm water habitat. When Pond Brook was first acquired, we did do aquatic ecological surveys, and we found that there was very little living in the prism of the ditch. The dominant fish was carp, and there was a high prevalence of delt anomalies. That stands for deformities, eroded fins, lesions, and tumors. And it's a sign of stress. Fish living in a stressful, uninviting environment often develop these features. Today, that's no longer the case. Many of the carp have been eliminated by the restoration of a natural habitat. The common carp doesn't really like natural habitats as much as it likes these impacted ditches. The fish communities have kind of rebounded to more of what you would expect in a warm water habitat. Warm water habitat is just reflective of overall good water quality. We have a good assemblage of native fish at different functional trophic levels. One of the other really surprising things and pleasant things that came back to this area were otters. I don't know if we can necessarily take the credit for the otters. They were kind of on the comeback anyway. But when they got to Pond Brook, they found a much more inviting environment than they otherwise would have. This project could not have been done without a number of partners. It was funded via numerous sources, including mitigation money from the Ohio Department of Transportation, the WRRSP program, the Section 319 program, and the Clean Ohio Conservation Fund. These were all sources of funding for the restoration of this work. It was an ongoing project, and it was a lengthy endeavor. It did require a lot of earth moving, and any time you are going to move a significant amount of dirt, there's a big cost to the restoration work, and not only cost, but time. But we stuck with it and persevered, and over the course of these years, we have re-sculpted a natural landscape that is, at least so far, it appears to be sustainable. We have not had to go back in and do maintenance. That was one of the goals that we sought to achieve, is we did not want to have to create a new environment that would require constant maintenance. We have now been in the monitoring phase, and we have seen not only a comeback of the fish communities, but all of the associated wildlife. The wetlands in particular draw migratory birds, especially waterfowl. During the late fall and winter months, they utilize these areas as migratory stopovers. Again, that was something that was not originally planned, but it was a really nice thing to see in the final result. The project not only involved re-sculpting the land and reforming channels, it also involved the planting of thousands and thousands of trees and native shrubs.
the vegetation and biodiversity of the plant life has rebounded as well. Invasive species management was something that was very important in the project, something that we worked on extensively throughout the course of this endeavor. We hope that this is a habitat that will persevere now and be a benefit not only to the fish and wildlife, but to the people of Summit County and the patrons who visit our park.